those also have these small LCDs with them. Okay, it is 16x2 LCD. Okay, what is the mean by 16x2 LCD? It means it has 16 rows and 2 columns. Okay, sorry, 16 columns and 2 rows. It's 16x2. So it has 16 columns. Means suppose this is a matrix. Okay, and it has 16 columns. Means it has 1, 2. For example, from here to here, it has 16 columns, and we have 1 and 2. Okay, these are called rows. Okay, so whatever we see horizontally is rows, and whatever we see vertically is column. Okay, so today we are going to make a small program. This is first I will show you that how this program is. So let me clear this first. So I will create this first. Okay. So we are going to print this hello world. Okay. On our LCD with the help of this Arduino and a potentiometer, a resistance, some wires, and a breadboard. Okay. 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 The things we required. Okay. So first we required this LCD. So we need LCD. Okay. Let me make a note for you. So we'll have a notepad for you. So you first need an LCD. LCD 16x2. Then we need Arduino. Okay. Then we need breadboard. Okay. Then we need potentiometer and anything else. So we need a potentiometer. Okay. Okay, and a 220 ohm. And anything else, things which you require, okay. And I'm sending you this. Okay. So these 5 things you should take. Need to be done with this one, okay. Then we can together make a new circuit for that. So this is a connection. Yeah, I'm not speaking. So these are the connections. Okay. And so you need to change in this one, okay. So this is not 10 gate, it's 220 ohm. 220 ohm. something else remains. Let me tell you about the things which we do. Okay, so you know about Arduino, you know about breadboard, you have used the potentiometer, and you know about the resistor also. Okay, so it stops the flow of current, nothing new in all of these. Okay, the thing which is left is LCD. Okay, so we'll discuss a short about LCD, and then we make. Let me make a new circuit for a look to show how the connections are going to be done. Okay, this time carefully note it down. Okay, and see that which connection is which wire is hooked to which pin. Okay, so if you don't do the right connection, your LCD will not glow. Okay, so this is a very important part. I need all of you to focus here. Okay, please tell. Okay, so this is very important part. Okay, so you don't miss a single point. Okay. Don't just come and go. Okay. So from our notepad. Okay. So first thing we need is 16x2 LCD. Okay. So first we will see where the 16x2 LCD. Okay. So you can write here 16 and 2x2. Okay. So you will get this LCD. If you can write the LCD also, it will come. Make it sound like we have the LCD. Okay. After that, we need. Okay, so you can have this also. Starter. Starter is also LCD. This one. We need this. So this is a starter. So we have the starter bit. Okay. You can have this also. So you can have this. Okay, if you don't want to make a circuit, okay, so you can have this, you can use it directly. Okay. But the point is that if you don't understand how it's done internally, then there is no use of. Hanging a little bit. My voice is coming small. Okay. Okay, let me make a new circuit for it. Okay. Because last circuit was hanging, and I will create a new one. I don't have computer book. Okay. The first option is take the starter kit. Okay. You can click it and you can simultaneously run it. It will work, but we need to do it manually. Okay, how we can do it manually? Okay, so it's printing a hello world and it's changing what we have. Okay, that's good. We can do it directly, but we need to understand what is the how it is working. Okay, what is the science behind it, and we will construct it by our own hand. Okay, we are not using that startup. Okay, let's stop that simulation and I just. So we will create our own LCD. This is a 16x2 LCD. Okay. The next thing we need is we need Arduino. The thing which you need to remember is your Arduino pins and the pin of LCD. Okay. So the data pin must be oriented. So I just what I will do, I will just orientate it, rotate it to a particular position. So it is easy for me to make the certificate. Then we need a breadboard. Okay, so we have our own breadboard. So in this way we can have a very good circuit. Okay, so remember this position. These are digital pins close to the LCD pins. Okay, remember that. Okay, now we need to connect everything. Okay, so let's go to the connection. Make another. Okay, I have send you the tokens. This is our required equipment. So we have taken the LCD, we have taken the breadboard, but we have not taken the potentiometer and 220 ohm resistor. So first, we need to take the potentiometer and 220 ohm resistor. Okay. So from the basic component list, okay. So I have the potentiometer here. Need to type. Okay, so I'll just put it here. And we need a resistor. Okay, here's the resistor. Okay, so let's see its value. Okay, its value is 1 kilo ohm, which is 1000 ohm. We need 220 ohm resistor. Note it down, everyone. 220 ohm, no more, no less. Only 220 ohm. Okay, so it is a symbol. See once again. Okay, it is a symbol for ohm, kilo ohm, and all that. Okay, so 1 kilo ohm is equal to 1000 ohm. Now my voice is coming right, or it is low? It's not coming right. Many students are saying that my voice is not coming. Okay. I will speak a little bit louder. Okay. So we have connected all these things, and this is 22 ohm resistor. Just put it here. Okay. Now the thing is, we are going to do is we are going to supply power. Okay. So power is 5 volt. We need to give 5 volt to everything. Okay. So first, what we will do? We will give 5 volt to this over this circuit. Okay. So I will take this 5 volt from here. I'm first connecting my 5 volt to my breadboard. Okay, now I'm making this whole row as 5 volt. Okay, next thing we are going to do is we are taking the ground. Thank you. Okay, so we have connected 5 volt with our breadboard. Okay, now we need to connect the 5 volt to our potentiometer also. Okay, so, and to this LCD also. So we need to connect it. So as we know that we have this, what we call it, this entire row is 5 volt and this is ground. So first we need to connect with our LCD. So I'm taking a positive voltage from here. Remember the color code. Taking a positive volt from here. Okay. So it's 5 volts, so I'm giving it a red. That's red. And I'm connecting the ground. Okay, I'm taking the ground in the same place. Okay. Okay, make your circuit clean, otherwise you yourself cannot understand which wire is going to be. Okay, and use the color code. Color code means where use red for the 5 volt and black for the ground. Okay, so we have connected the LCD. We have given power to the LCD. Okay, now our power is system. Okay, now we need to give power to our potentiometer. We need to give power from the meter. So I am taking here. You know that in the potentiometer, this one is positive terminal, this one is the negative terminal, and it is the variable resistance. It is the output. Okay. So we connect this, and I'm making the function. I'm making it black. Okay. So you have 1 second. Make it long. So I'm done long. I need to connect from this. Okay. The first step. Your first step is okay. The first step is to connect everything from. To give power to everything. Okay. So how you give power to everything? You give power by giving it a 5 volt and a ground. Okay, so I'm giving me a 5 volt and a ground to LCD. I'm giving the 5 volt and a ground to this board, and I'm giving the 5 and a ground to this potential. Okay, so till now we have set everything. Okay, now after that, what next step we do? We'll go to our documentation and we see there. Okay, so it is RS pin. What is RS? RS in the LCD. RS in the LCD, we need to find the RS in the LCD. So, junior LCD. Okay? So, this is RS. Okay. It is connected with okay. So, this is RS and RS is connected with pin number 12. Okay? So, we will connect it with pin number 12. So, this is RS and okay. So, we use like this and this is pin number 12. These are data pins, so we will color code them. Okay, so first is we will color the yellow. What happened now? Ma'am, it is really low, or these bits are okay.
Yes, sir, little bit it's low.
Okay, ma'am, I will speak a little louder. So I'm connecting the data pins. I'm connecting the data pins. So first is RS is connected with pin number 12. Okay. So RS is connected with pin number 12. Next. Okay. So we need to do the next one. That is enable pin to pin number 11. Okay. So we have this enable pin, and this enable pin must be connected to pin number 11. We come here, go here, and we connect. So we are color coding the. Yeah, color coding the data pins. Okay, so
yeah,
Okay, the next is pin number 5 to D4. Okay, so D4 to pin number 5, we need to see the D4. Okay, here is the D4, and it needs to be connected with pin number 5. So I'm taking from here, okay, and pin number 5. D4, and it needs to be connected to pin number 5. Okay. So, better. Other two of this, okay, so pin left. Okay. After that, the next pin is see the pins. Okay, the next pin is pin number 4 is there. Now D6 to pin number 3. Okay. D6 to pin number 3 is a D6. I'll take the D6. Okay, and I will come here and connect with pin number 4. Okay. D6 is connected with pin number 4. Okay, so now next is D7. D7 should be connected to pin number 3. Okay, and we'll change it color code, we'll make it to brown. Okay, so you just remember that each have there. Okay, so you left D5, I think. Okay, so then put that in this A. Okay, so after D4, we need a D5. Okay, so we have this D5 to pin number 4. It is in a decreasing order. So we have this. So we have D5 and we connected to pin number 4. Okay. Color code this. And we will color code this pin. Okay. And we have D6. I'm connecting D6. I'm connecting D6 with pin number 3. Gets we need to okay. So we are connected. Make it color code purple. So now the last one, and it need to be connected to pin number 2. Okay. After that, we have this gray. Okay. So we're connected like this. Okay. So it has been connected. Okay. So now now we need to connect these two and this V0 pin. Okay. So why this V0 pin? Okay. So it is for the contrast. Okay. It will adjust the contrast. Okay. So what is contrast? The brightness. Okay. So you have seen the brightness in your phone. Okay. So when there is when you are out in the sunlight, okay, so your mobile screen is not visible. What you do, you scroll down in mobile and you increase your brightness of the mobile, okay. And when it is night, your brightness of the phone is very high, you scroll down and what you do, you reduce the brightness of your phone, okay. In the same way, this pin is used to brighten the color of LED and de-brighten the color of LED, and we will vary it with the help of potentiometer. Got it? So I think we need a little bit. Okay. And I'm connecting it with this potentiometer. Okay, and I'm making it orange. Okay, so it is taking the input, so that's why I'm making it orange. Okay. So we are adjusting the brightness with the help of potentiometer. What potentiometer do? It increase or decrease the current of it increase or decrease the current flow through it. Okay, so if you want more brightness, we decrease the potentiometer. If you want a less brightness, we increase the potentiometer. Okay, in this way we will dial the potentiometer and our LCD brightness will be more or it will be less. Okay, it's done. Okay, now the next thing we need to do is we need to give anode and cathode. Okay, so it is for the backlight. Okay, so everything has a backlight for the light which is for the background. Okay, so for this background light, what we are doing is we are connecting with a 5 volt with end resistance. Okay, if you don't allow the resistance, it won't be bright that much. Okay, what we are doing is I'm taking from here, and I'm connecting back here. So this is also anode, so I need to make it the color code red. Okay, and we need the ground. Okay, so we need to connect the ground, so we can connect it here also. Okay, so it's fine to connect it here. And I will connect it with black. So our LCD is ready for the all connection. Okay, let's try the code. Okay, so it has the code for that looping statement. We don't require this code. Okay, so we will write our own code. If our circuit is right, we can easily able to do that. Okay. So, anyone has doubt in the circuiting? So, anyone has doubt in the circuitry? So, Okay, so I have sent you the return statements also. So I have sent you that all the things to how you can connect it. Okay, the one thing is that you need only the 2K resistance. Okay, very good, very good. Everyone just hook it up. Okay, we don't have that. Okay, let's check our code if it's working or not. Okay. So I'm writing my code first. Okay. So first we need to include a library. Okay. So what is a library? Okay. Very good. Okay. Very good. Okay. So we need a library. Okay. So this is a keyword. Okay. So what is the keyword? Keyword is something which has a meaning. Okay. Suppose till now we are using void loop, we are using print. Okay. So they all have something. Okay. They all have some meanings. Okay. They all have some meanings in the similar way. In the similar way. Yes. What happened now? I am trying my best. Okay. I'm just trying my best. I don't know why it's coming low. Okay. It's coming loud now. Hello. Anyone can give me the feedback now. It's coming loud now. Okay. Okay. That's my audio settings and it's loud. Okay. So first we need to include a library. Okay. What is the library? Can anyone define what is the library? Simple library that is in your school. Why we use that library? Can anyone say why you use the library? Kids, tell me what is the library is, and do you go library in your school or not? Tell me fast. Okay. So library is a place where you have a lots of books. Okay, if we are talking about a school library or a institutional library, so it has a books place where we have a lots of books for a different field and different sectors. Okay, in the same way, in the computer, to have a lots of information, we have a library. Okay, so every time we don't need to have a lots of information, we don't need to write every time a lots of information. What we will do? We will use the things from the library. Okay, we cannot buy every book. Okay, so we cannot buy every book. We don't have that much fund. So what we'll do if we require, if I will have to done a project in science or in physics, okay. So what we'll do, we'll take a book from the library, 3-4 books from the library, and find out the thing which is helpful for us, okay. And and print them. In the same way, we are taking books from the library. We are taking the data from this library. This is LCT crystal. Okay, so it is a library for our LCT. Okay. And now I am defining the pins. Okay, so we are defining RS equals to 11, EN equals to 11. Okay, that's we have done in our circuiting. So we are doing that. So D4, D5, and we have D5 equals to 4. Okay, and we have D6 equals to 3, and we have D7 equals to 2. Okay. Okay, I have defined that, and we need to okay, so this is the function which we are using, and we are defining the pins here. Okay, so we have RS enable. Okay, we have D4. If we write it down, then I will explain a little bit better. D6, D7. Okay, and okay, so it's done. Okay, so we have defined all our pins. Okay, so what we have defined. Okay, my battery is going low. Okay, guys, give me 2 minutes and I am coming. Ma'am, I am coming in just 2 minutes. Okay, so there is a power shortage. find someone else to buy.
Okay, so we have a stinker cat. Sign in. It's taking a time, okay, so be patient. Okay. So I have a circuit. I created a new circuit. Okay, so I'm not making the circuit again. I'm using the circuit starter kit. Okay, so I need to explain only the LCD. Okay, so we have the starter kit. So I'm not using that again. Okay, so let me see the show you the code because we have left very less time left. Okay. So it is the same thing. Okay, so we have included our library, which is LCD dot h. Okay, after that we have defined all the pins that we are defining there. Okay, after that we are using columns and the rows. Okay, so we are setting the, we are telling that LCD dot begin. Okay, it is a function. LCD is an object and it is a function of this object. Okay, so we are not going to the object and all those detail stuff. You can understand it is a function, it is sort of function, just like we have that function that move the motors, okay, print on the serial monitor, LCD dot begin, okay, delay dot h, okay, so that sort of function. So what it do is tells our Arduino that we are using an LCD in 16 cos 2 LCD. Okay, after that what we'll say that we are printing hello world in there. Okay, and I will just remove everything else from here. I think we need to code by ourselves. Okay, so where we are, okay, so just I remove all these things. Okay, so let make us our code very 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 specific, very clear. Okay, so we don't need everything else like this. Okay, and I just clean everything else and I will start running the program. Okay, so let's see it works or not. Okay, so we start running the program. Okay, so it's showing me the hello world. Okay, so how it's happening. Okay, so it's happening with the help of this function, which is said LCD dot print hello world. Okay, you need to understand this much only. Okay, okay. Now, if you want to print something else, okay, not hello world, something else. So I'm just trying to print hello in the place of hello world. I was to say my friend name is Aman. Okay, once again, just stop that first. Okay, so I just say okay. So my friend name is Aman. Okay, and I will tell Aman that I say hello Aman to. Okay, so it will can run the same thing. Okay, so whenever you need to change the thing, you need to change here. Okay, you don't need to change anywhere else. Every program remains the same. Okay, so now if you want to print something else from Aman, okay, if you want to print a number, okay, so you can print that also. Okay, so we can have that. Okay, it's not working, I think. Okay, so first finish. Sorry, I need to stop that. Okay, so you can, these are strings. Okay, strings is okay, so you can print number also. So for that we need to define a number also. So I will define an integer, which is I, okay, and equals to 1. Okay, so I equals to 1. This is a simple statement. What I am saying that I am telling that it is a variable. Okay, I told you about the variables. Okay, we are dealing it from the first lecture. Okay, and I want to print that I. Okay, so what I will do is I will say LED dot print in the place of first second one second. Just I give you the code, then only we can have that. Okay, so for the next stage. Okay, so I'm sending you the first code for LCD. Okay, try to run it. copying you and I'm sending you. Where is our, okay, here is there. Need a chat and we need to paste it here. Okay, so this is our first code. Okay, I don't try to download this and try to run it. Okay, after that what you will do, you will make your own LCD circuit with the help of things which I have provided you. Okay, got it everyone? Hello, is anyone have a doubt?